Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial about the Angular Image Editor component. This component comes with an efficient graphical user interface that allows you to open and edit the image. The Image Editor provides built-in support to zoom, crop image based on selection, add annotation, rotate, and to convert images to different graphical formats like JPEG, PNG, and SVG. In this video, I will show you how to add the SyncFusion Angular Image Editor to an Angular app. Now, let me show you the steps to create an Angular project using the Angular CLI tool. I will edit my code using Visual Studio Code. I will view the output result on Google Chrome, but any of the supported browsers will work. First, you need to install the Angular CLI on your machine using this command, npm install -g at angular/cli. Since I have already installed the Angular CLI on my machine, I am skipping this step here. Next, I am going to create a new Angular project, so I use this command, ng new project name. I have named my project Editor Example. Here, I am going to create a project without the routing option, so let me set no for this option. I will choose the CSS option to add a CSS stylesheet in the Angular project. This will create an Angular project along with its dependencies. Now, let me navigate to the project folder. To use the SyncFusion Angular Image Editor, I install the SyncFusion Angular Image Editor package using this command. npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularimageeditor --save. This will install the Angular Image Editor package along with its dependencies. Now, I am going to open this application in Visual Studio Code. The first thing I need to do is navigate to the app module file and import the Image Editor module from the SyncFusion EJ2 Angular Image Editor package. Then, I register the same module within the Imports array of the ng module section. Next, open the main TS file to register the SyncFusion Angular trial license key. Let me import the register license method from the SyncFusion EJ2 base package first. Then, register the Angular trial license key using the register license method. From the 2022 Volume 1 release onwards, it is required to register the Angular license key. After that, I need to define the Angular Image Editor component. To do that, let me open the app component HTML file and remove the existing content. Then, I will add a division element with style attribute to set height and width for the division element. Next, I define Angular Image Editor component using EJS Image Editor tag inside this division element. Now, I am going to define CSS for the image editor, so let me open the style.css file and import the material theme. Here, I have added the dependency CSS references like buttons, lists, pop-ups, navigations, and inputs. Then, I run the application using the command ng-serve. Okay, this example is compiled successfully, so let me navigate to the output page. Look at this page, the image editor is rendered with a file browser icon. Click the browser icon and select an image from the local path. You can see the Angular Image Editor component displayed with the selected image. Notice here, the toolbar is enabled with the image editing options. Using this zoom in option, you can zoom in on the image and move the zoomed region in both horizontal and vertical directions with the pan option. You can zoom out of the zoomed region using the zoom out option. Now, I am going to crop the image, so let me choose the crop option in the toolbar. This pop-up opens with different options like custom, circle, square, and various aspect ratios. Here, I will select the image region using the circle option and crop that region. Next, I am going to edit the image, so let me click this annotation option. The pop-up opens with different options to add an annotation to the image. I can draw any annotation freehand. Include a supported shape. And add text in the image. If you want to know more about this annotation option, check the documentation link in the description. Okay, next, I am going to rotate the image left, so let me click the transform option and choose rotate left. See the editor now, the image is rotated to the left. Similarly, you can also rotate the image to the right and flip the image in both the directions, horizontally and vertically. Apart from these options, you can reset the changes in the editor using the reset option. And use the save option to download the image in the supported formats. Okay, I have shown you everything about the toolbar options and how they work. Next, I will show you how to open an image in the image editor at initial loading. I can open an image using a hosted link or online URL link, image data, or Base64. For this demo, I plan to open the image using a hosted link. To do this, first I will define the created event with an event handler, OpenImage. Then, I navigate to the app component TS file and define the OpenImage event handler method here. Inside this method, I am going to make a call to the built-in method of image editor named Open. To access this built-in method of image editor here, I need to create an instance for the image editor component first. So, I open the app component HTML file and add a reference variable, image editor. Then, I go back to the app component TS file and add a view child directive and pass that reference variable, image editor. Next, I define a variable named editor object of type image editor component. You can see here, the view child directive and the image editor component class are imported automatically from the appropriate packages. Now, inside the event handler method, I make a call to the open method by using the image editor instance. To this open method, I will pass the ej2demoImageURL link as an argument. Look at the output page now, the image editor is displayed with the image from the online URL link. As I said before, I can save the image using the save option in the toolbar with a default file name and chosen file format. Suppose I want to save the image with a different file name, then I can use the export method. I am planning to save the image in PNG format with the file name SyncFusion by using a button click. So, let me define a division element with style attribute and set the top padding with the value to 20 pixels. To align the button component in the output page. Then, I will add the button element with the content click. Next, I set the class attribute value to eButton within this button element. Now, I am going to set the button to primary, so let me add the class eprimary to the class attribute. Next, I will add the click event with an event handler. Then, navigate to app component TS file and define the save image method here. Within this method, let me call the export method using the image editor instance and pass the first argument as PNG and second argument as SyncFusion. See the output page now. When I click the button, the image is downloaded with the name SyncFusion and in PNG format. In this video, we have seen how to create an Angular project using Visual Studio Code and how to add a SyncFusion Angular image editor to it. We have also seen how to select a region in the image and crop it. Finally, we also saw how to load an image initially and save it with a different file name. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. You can also check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire Angular suite, with the link in the description. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.